Hey everyone, and welcome to this little tutorial. Today we'll simulate cloud shadows with Unity URP and the Shadergraph. First, we're gonna create an unlit shader. We call it Clouds Receiver, and a subgraph, and we're gonna call it Clouds Mask. Let's begin with the subgraph. Here we'll create cloud's shape. I'll show you one solution, but obviously you can create any shapes you want to apply as a mask. Here I'll use a gradient noise. So first, set the subgraph output as a vector one and I call it cloud's mask. Now let's create a gradient noise node. It needs a vector two as UV and the scale will represent our cloud's shadow's size. The gradient noise node returns values between 0 and 1, but I want to remap these values depending on the shadow's density I want. So let's use a remap node and we'll create a custom function. It's pretty simple and it defines the min-max values depending on the input density. We create a new property to set the density value. Then we want to manage the global shadow strength. So we multiply the remap result by a cloud strength property. Finally, as we are creating a mask, we want to return the reverse value. So we use the 1 minus node. Save it, and we are done with the subgraph. Now let's shake the main shader. Open it and add the subgraph node. At the end, we'll multiply the object color by the mask value of the subgraph. But before it works, we need to set properties to our subgraph. First, the UV. Here, we're not gonna use the object UV, but UV is relative to world space. To do that, we get the object position in world space, and we use the X and Z values as UV. Then, we need to set the cloud's shadow size, density and strength properties. So, let's create them and set the density and the strength as sliders with values between 0 and 1. I set the shader in a specific folder and I save it before trying it. I put the shader on a material I set to every object of my scene and play with values. As you can see, it works, but it doesn't move. So let's fix it. Go back to Shadergraph and we will use the time node. We'll multiply it by a vector 2 so we can set the cloud's direction with it. And we multiply the result by a speed property. We put the result in the offset property field of the tiling and offset node, and it's done! Save the shader and let's try it! It was my very first tutorial video, so thanks for watching it, and I hope it will help you in your dev journey. Please let me know if you liked the video and if there are things I can improve for the next one. See you and good dev!